Hi, welcome everybody to God Games. The games that God himself created, because he created everything. I'll have to find where that is in the Bible, but we'll just say it's in Genesis. Most people don't know where it is. But so today we're going to do a Nintendo Dual System, or Nintendo DS ROM, using this PC Windows emulator. I'm using Windows 10 or 11. But you can use, I think, XP and up with this emulator. Though there's probably different versions of the emulator. This one's called $GBA. And one thing is, before you run the ROM, you might have to extract it. And now there is a built-in extractor. There are third-party software extractors like WinRAR or WinZip, and sometimes one works and one doesn't. I've actually had that real experience. So if it doesn't work, don't get rid of it and give it a try. Yeah. Okay. So you want to unzip it in the directory closest to where the tree opens, so you don't have to run through like a dozen or half a dozen windows. So I just put it in the same folder as the emulator, or as the Nintendo DS one. And here it is, the NDS file. If you open up the zip, it doesn't work. I've tried it. We can do it right here. So, you know, oh, it does work. Wow, okay, sometimes it works. All right, we'll try. Okay, it does work. I'm just windowing it. So it starts out like this. There's a white screen, Nintendo splash, and then you got different options here. You can turn on the music on and off, and you can choose one of only three different songs. I think the most annoying one is the swing. It doesn't sound like swing music to me. It reminds me of like Final Fantasy RPG running music. So let's just go with jazz. Tutorials once, we'll keep that on just to, for all the people new. So this Monopoly game is for Nintendo DS. And so once you click on new game, you can pick up to four different players. Some games allow you more. Or some versions of Monopoly, and we'll do a side-by-side comparison of that later on. So I have a ROM for a Genesis one, and I think I have a NES version too. And then, so by default, you're the first guy. You can be anywhere on this list, I think. Let's see if we can do it. Yeah, you can be on the right here. Well, let's see it. And you can be one of these icons. In this version, interestingly, you don't choose a name. So let's put, I like the dog. But I haven't tried the other one, so I'm kind of curious. So. Let's see the thimble. Because the iron kind of flips around, which is kind of interesting at first, but it's annoying. It kind of makes you dizzy and annoyed looking at it. So, here I'm the human one. I like being the ship, to be honest. But, I'll be the boot today to see what that's like. I haven't seen that animation. And the difficulty, you can choose three different ones. Easy, normal, and hard. We'll put on easy. Last time I put on easy, the computer wouldn't trade with me, so that was kind of a pain. I only had a few grand in cash, and even just for one property for like 2,000, I couldn't get the computer to trade with me. So I'll have to figure out how to edit this ROM someday. Options enabled, yes. I prefer this one, but you can save some money sometimes that way. Properties at start. This one's an interesting one. Some versions of Monopoly, like the Genesis one, doesn't have this one. Obvious, obviously are ready to go or built in, but maybe it's in the software hidden. We'll have to dig in that. And you only have three options, either two properties per person, four, or all. And we're gonna go with all, so you can see what that looks like. Limited houses, sure. What's it, other Ness and Nolan, okay. Free parking money, I prefer. I'm gonna put taxes on that one. So the taxes go to the free parking money space, which you actually own the hard paper board game, the original. You can actually put your taxes there, and then whoever lands on it gets the money, which helps. And then your initial money, you can choose between 1,000, 1,500, or 2,000. I'm gonna go with the highest of 2,000. Pasco salary by default is 200, or you can put none. But I'm gonna put 400. And then land on go salary, I'm gonna put double. Usually it's 200, so now it's gonna be 400. So this is pretty much the highest money setup that you have ready to go. And to start the game, I was playing this on a phone Android emulator called Gen Plus, so it was kind of hard for me to find the buttons here. On that emulator, if you get the overlay of the controls, you can turn that off and it makes it easy to play. Okay. I can't remember if I'm the thimble or the shoe. I'm the shoe, sorry. I think. Go back three spaces. Don't get any income tax goes there. And this guy's gonna go through the tutorial. Sorry if I'm going too fast. I'll have to make a version where it's slow. Kinda in a hurry. He had 2,000 and he already paid 1,600. Oh, because he built a bunch of houses I didn't see right here on the boardwalk. God, see, sometimes the thing about the, like, all properties handed out, sometimes the computer has the advantage and has more than you have in the same groups. And that's what happened to me the first time. It doesn't always happen. But if you notice that, check it out and then reset the game. Or learn how to be a software engineer and edit it. That's pretty much your two options. Or you could pray for a miracle, but I don't think that third one happens by itself. There's that verse from St. Paul that says, prayer without work is dead. Or at least half alive. So. So I own all these purple ones here. Okay, it's explaining all this. This only happens once the first time you run the game, if it saves the state. So, okay. So to manage the property, you have to click on this icon here, which I wasn't sure if this was just build only, but the one that looks like a little blue house. You actually have to hit that first, then on the property you want. So, and then you click. Oh. Am I the blue one? I thought that was blue. Oh, I'm not blue, I'm the yellow. So the colors have changed. Okay, so the colors depend on the position you're in. Okay. So I used to be the one on the right, so I was blue. Okay, this is how you increase the houses here. There's a confirmation button, or a commit build button, as it's called. So we can build, and the total cost is at the bottom. But sometimes I've noticed this cost is higher than what's subtracted. So let's go with. Let's go with 500. I might get lucky. here. So you'll notice the properties that you have. If you play where nobody has anything in the beginning, this will all be empty, but otherwise this little like half circle. The colors correspond to the players. So the one on the top right here is yellow, and that's me. And then the other color is blue. I'm not sure what the third and fourth colors are. I haven't played with four players yet. So we're gonna build here. So currently, if the player lands on here, the rent's this much. If you mortgage it, it's zero. You know, one house price is different per the property. So let's go with, oh wait, I don't like this one. For some reason, I feel like the players land on a certain space more so than the others. So you know, 800. But I only have 300 in cash. Alright, I'll just do $900. I get lucky the player will land on it, but if not, he'll just go buy it, which is most likely. So I've played this a few times and it's been like that. Now, if you're wondering, you can trade with the player. You can trade it, but whether they accept it, it's sometimes difficult to get control of a property. Right, well, let's give it a try here so you see the trading screen. So by default, the other player, the second player, is what you see. It's kind of confusing. You click on their icon here, see it goes. Get tour tutorials going, trying to teach us how to do this. But here, by default, the bimbo is selected. This is, so don't get the confused. If you look closely, there's like a little edge. You can see there's an overlay. So what I want is actually this property here. So you click on the property, and you click on this icon with the green check mark. And then when it has a dark check mark, it's selected. And then let's just try a simple one item trade here. And let's go with 250. 250, it's like a 10 keypad, and then this is the enter, accept, or no button, the agreement handshake thing. It's kind of cool, other monopolies, you don't even see that. And then you see the two different things, make sure that, check this out, but once you do it, it's kind of hard to undo unless you constantly save and your saves reload, right? It says, are you sure you want to make this offer? You have two choices, yes or no. And I just declined the offer, so it's not going to go. Alright, we'll just end the turn. Now, the view of the board is kind of at an angle, which is different versus like the 8-bit Genesis and NES versions. Plus, there's some extra items around the board, which is kind of like a plate with a, I think it's a bagel. I keep thinking it's a donut, but actually looking closely, it looks more like a bagel. And then up at the top, there's what looks like cheese puffs. And then there's a pile of money here, which I'm sure you can interact with it somehow if you reprogrammed it. And then on this board at the bottom, the little blue circle, only one circle appears at a time, is where the blue player company right now. We're gonna roll. Normally you only get to roll once, but if you roll doubles, you get to roll again up to the third time, and that sends you automatically to jail. Okay. Let's see if we get lucky. No, see, it goes right by all my properties. Alright. And so, that's it. So that's our preview of Monopoly. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see ya. And check it out. You can Google search the ROM and the emulator. No GBA. It's Nintendo DS. And it's only 15 megabytes, so it's a pretty small phone. Alright, check it out, everybody. Thanks for watching, and God bless everybody.